that's the story of the time at the moment. There's so many glitches around, but life is still beautiful. When you talk about captaincy, when you talk about leadership, there are so many things. This is not a guideline that you have to be the best player of the side, but right. Perform when your team needs. We are going through a very low phase as far as Indian cricket was concerned, coming out of that match fixing and all those things were going around at that time. It was not a very easy time for somebody like him. Well, IPL is a very hot tournament.
Yes.
आपको गंभीर का सिर्फ गुस्सा क्यों दिखता है? आपको आपको तो नाम से ही पता होना चाहिए कि वो गंभीर है.
Hello and welcome to SK Live. I'm your host Shanvi Sadana. Today we have with us former Indian cricketer and former assistant coach of KKR and head talent scout of the Delhi Capitals, Mr. Vijay Bhaiya. A very warm welcome to you.
Thank you so much.
How are you doing? How's Neh? How's Veera?
All good, all good. Luckily, God has been very kind. Things are fine at home. Things are fine in the neighborhood as well. You know how the conditions are in Delhi. So yeah, so far, so good.
That's good. And are you ready for the IPL?
I think the whole world is ready for the IPL, to be very honest. It's the kind of tournament that you look forward to. And must give credit to BCCI, think tank, that's sitting there and deciding that the conditions are not ideal as far as India is concerned at the moment, but tournament should go on. And that's why we're moving to UAE. I'm sure everybody is eagerly waiting for this big event to start.
Yes. So you have the experience to guide a team to winning an IPL trophy. How prepared is Delhi team this season?
Well, I'll just come in for your question. You said the guide. I was part of a support staff or a team. You know, when you talk about team sport, it's played by individuals, but in the end, it's a team sport. So every person have played their part, and that's what happened. You just mentioned about KKR. You know, guided about that two wins that we had, two fantastic wins that we had. But things are completely different if we compare that to right now. And it's different because of the conditions. Ideally, by now, the team get together, start preparing. But because of this pandemic, we didn't get a chance. We picked up a brilliant side. We picked up a very good mix as far as our team is concerned in the auction. Really looking forward. Played really well last season. Have that momentum going in. But unfortunately, didn't get any opportunity to train together yet. So yeah, looking forward when we can start and get back to the ground and then assess from there and then go on.
Okay. And are the Delhi Capitals the favorites to win the tournament?
I think, you know, if you ask any side, if you ask side who's a winner for a couple of times, they'll also say that when you start the tournament, ideal thought or ideal preparation should be try and at the top half of the table in the mid of the tournament and then, you know, try and get into the last four. Nobody can decide who's going to win, but you prepare keeping that in mind and just be right at the top of the group and then see it from there. It's difficult to say. You always prepare really well. You want to prepare really well. You have that sort of a confidence in your group, but it's tough to say that you're going to be a favorite or not.
Okay, so will the team be missing the services of Sourav Ganguly after what he did last year with the team?
I was not part of the team last year round, but when it comes to Sourav, I don't have to be there to feel the impact that he can make to any side or any organization. I was lucky enough when I made my debut for India, Sourav was the captain, and I know from there only the kind of impact that he brings to any team. He's been phenomenal. And then what I've heard from the people I have interacted as far as Delhi Capital is concerned, his impact was immense. And I think whatever values that he put in, whatever chat that he had with players, whatever impact that he has made, a lot of people, a lot of individuals, a lot of youngsters will carry on that. But yeah, as far as that individual presence is concerned, yes, you'll definitely miss a figure like him, which is a huge figure as far as Indian cricket is concerned.
Yes, and you have also played under Sourav Ganguly. And what was special about his captaincy?
I think, you know, when you talk about captaincy, when you talk about leadership, there are so many things. As a captain or as a leader, you're not supposed to be, this is not a guideline that you have to be the best player of the side. But right. Perform when your team needs and make a team. You know, when Sourav Ganguly got the captaincy of India. Everybody knows we are going through a very low phase as far as Indian cricket was concerned, coming out of that match fixing and all those things were going around at that time. It was not a very easy time for somebody like him. But credit to him. He had that neck, he had that patience, and he had that eye. And I think he backed a lot of people. And that's the reason why we are where we are as far as Indian cricket is concerned. And we have so many names, we have so many stars who've been backed then by Sourav Ganguly. And that's the whole idea of a good leader or a good captain to back his players. He's done a phenomenal win. And there's another thing that he's done, which is another brilliant sign. He gave you freedom to express yourself. It's not that, you know, he was controlling you from any angle. He gave you that freedom, go out there, and no matter what, once he packed you till the hilt. So that's a trademark of any good leader or any good captain.
That's very true. So coming back to the IPL, how do you see Delhi Capitals shaping up under their captain, Shreyas Iyer?
A young captain, but he'll get a lot of confidence the way the team has played last year. This is, you know, we talk about momentum, we talk about what you've done. Although it was last year, but I still believe he's maturing, and that's what you need. Played a regular part as far as the Indian side is concerned, which is very, very good for him as an individual. And you need, as an individual, you need a confident person out there. And I think this gives you an additional responsibility and honor when you are a captain of a top side or for a tournament like IPL, which is one of the best T20 leagues in the world. So I think with age, with his experience, with every outing out there, with Ricky Ponting around, who's one of the best captain in the world, who's be there as a chief coach, I think every time he's going to go out there and get better. And the other thing that we need to add when we talk about Shreyas, he's a fast learner. That's another very good quality that you need in a leader who wants to go out there, get better every time, have a lot of communication with people. And that's a plus point as far as Shreyas is concerned.
So I was asking, how crucial of a role do you think Ashwin will play?
Oh, absolutely, he'll play a very crucial role. There's no doubt about that. With so much of experience, when we talk about experience, which is so crucial, it'll be a new franchise for him. I think when we picked him up looking at the conditions at Delhi, which helps the spinners, and we have a couple of good spinners, Akshar and Amit Mishra, and we wanted Ashwin there. But it doesn't matter, even if the IPL is shifted to UAE, his experience will come very, very handy. And not only skill-wise, not only as a bowler, batsman, I think he's a very shrewd brain as well, very good student of cricket. He will contribute in every department. So yeah, he's going to be very, very crucial for us.
And also Delhi Capitals have a very right mix of youth and experience on their side. So what are your thoughts on that?
That's what I mentioned earlier. Like it was a very good auction for us. Everybody go with some sort of a favorite or the list that you want in an auction, and we came back very happy because we almost covered all the bases that we're looking for. It's not always going to happen in your favor that whatever the favorite list that you go by, you end up picking all of them. But we came back very happy, and especially because whatever gaps we wanted to fill, which we didn't have for last year. We were looking at them, and the mix of especially the Indian players, having Rahane coming to our side, having Ashwin. So, strengthening the domestic core even more what it was last year, having those options available to ourselves. So, yes, it looks a very good unit. Just waiting to get in the park and start practicing again.
Yes. And also, what about Shikhar Dhawan and Ajinkya Rahane? How would they be shaping up the tournament?
Very crucial. They're going to be very, very crucial for us because, you know, they'll be starting the innings. And let's not forget about Prithvi Shaw in the mix as well. He's somebody who's a pocket dynamo. And, we have very high hopes as far as Prithvi is concerned. He can give you the kind of start that you need, can set the tone. And this is what happened last year around. He was setting the tone. Shikhar Dhawan was playing a sheet anchor role. He was playing around. Other top order batsmen were playing around with him. And I think this is what is very, very important. Somebody needs to take that role. And the names that you have just mentioned have so much of experience, can change their game according to the situation as well. And yes, we're really looking forward to the top order of our batting.
And even Rabada last year was brilliant with the ball. What do you think?
What are your thoughts? What a player. What a player. It's a delight. It's a delight to see him. And if you look at the world cricket at the moment, there are very few fast bowlers who can change the course of the game, and he's one of them. And you know, the best thing, best news for us is he's maturing. He's getting close to his best. And the other thing, you know, you have to keep in mind, we just talk about the kind of conditions that we are in at the moment because of the pandemic. A lot of people have not played much cricket, but it's a good news as far as the fast bowlers are concerned. They've got that that break they have never got. So at the moment everything starts, the moment they start hitting the practice ground, the moment they start feeling everything once again, although the conditions are not that bad in South Africa, they have already played few matches. He's looking really good, and he's going to be very, very crucial for us. That's what Rabada is for us.
Yes, and also with no home advantage this year, how would it be for the IPL teams for the tournament?
You know, the good thing is, it's not that you playing a few games there and then coming back and changing. I think it's that the starting line is going to be the same for everyone, and once you have that, you don't have that sort of a mind block or anything sort of in your mind, because you know the playing condition, the rules, and everything is same for everyone. There's another thing that you playing in subcontinental sort of the conditions. It's not that you're going to New Zealand or going to Australia or England. So things going to be, you know, similar to what we play here all along the year. The weather, the atmosphere, the conditions more or less are the same, barring one or two grounds that you talk about. The ground in Abu Dhabi might challenge, but the wicket at Sharjah is going to be flat. Everybody knows that. But the only thing that we need to keep in mind is a lot of cricket happens in UAE. But because of this pandemic last couple of months, then nothing has happened. So everybody needs to go there, have a look, assess the conditions once again. But it's not that kind of condition where a lot of teams will be thinking, or let's say all the teams will be thinking that they have to change their combination, one or two player here and there. But not much changes are required as far as those conditions are concerned.
It's going to be a lot hotter, basically, a lot more hotter there.
Well, IPL is a very hot tournament.
Yes.
Well, you know, everybody is absolutely eager waiting. So,
yes.
Conditions, like you just mentioned, being hot there doesn't matter. People are so eager to get out there on the park and showcase and get down with the game. I think that's more important. But and there's another thing, you know, this has never happened that you got so much of time on hand. A lot of team will be traveling in early. A lot of team will be spending a lot of time together, which normally doesn't happen as far as IPL is concerned. Because if you look at the international cricket window, there's not that much of a gap in between where you spend a couple of weeks together, play as a team, get used to the conditions. But because of whatever happening all over the world at the moment, because of coronavirus, we will be getting a lot of time together. So we will get used to the conditions. I think most of the teams will be there 3 to 4 weeks in advance, which is a good enough time to get used to the conditions.
Okay. And tell us your experience working with Gautam Gambhir. What kind of a captain is Gambhir?
A very good captain, a very, very good leader. Leads from the front, that's another thing. He's a completely different person when he's on the field and off the field. You know, a lot of people judge him being what on the field is, but yeah, you're talking about leadership, and that's what you see on the field, not off the field. Phenomenal captain, got a very, very, very strong sense about this game. And once again, gives you that freedom as far as the players are concerned. Give them that freedom, give them, go out there and express yourself, and backs his player. This is another thing. You know, if you look back, this question is coming up because what we have done in 2012 and 2014, KKR won the IPL twice. If you look, I'll give you one example. Yusuf Pathan, Rajat Bhatia, and Gautam Gambhir were three players who played in that season all the games. You know, because of the condition, Rajat played his part, but Yusuf, he was backed. There was a lot of pressure on him Yusuf on himself as well, because he was not, having that sort of a run. But Gautam backed him, had a lot of chat with him. Support staff also had a chat with him and backed him and gave him this impression that, listen, you will win, and you will win a very crucial game for me. I have a lot of faith in you. And that's what he's done. Game against SRH that he won single-handedly at Eden. And straight away, we were into eliminator. So that's the kind of leadership. That's the kind of confidence that you need in your players. And that's what he's done. And I'm just giving you one of the examples. There are a lot of examples. the trump card for us was Sunil Narayan in 2012, or let's say the both the championship that KKR was able to win. And Gautam was the one who was so strong about having him in the side. I still remember before the auction, he was in Australia, Indian team was touring Australia. He called up and he said, no matter what, I want Sunil in my side. And that's the kind of leaders that you need backing your players going all the way. You know, nobody heard about Sunil that much. And right. after that season, everybody wanted a piece of Sunil Narayan. Right. So yeah. that's, and Sunil Narayan was the, one of the main reason as far as our 2012 championship was concerned.
Right. And it's so nice to see Indian coaches now in the IPL setup these days. What are your thoughts on that?
Very good. Very good. I mean, like, you know, it took some time. And when we talk about it's an Indian Premier League, you want when you promote Indian players, I'm sure it's another platform for as far as the Indian coaches are concerned. And a lot of people are showing faith. And I think a lot of people are producing results. That's very, very important. To produce results, on the other hand, you have to show faith, you have to give people time, you have to believe in them, and that's how the results will come. But it's very, very heartening to see that a lot of Indian coaches or Indian support staff are part of the most of the franchisees nowadays.
And there's also a concept of, players these days that in Delhi to push them young. And is that still going on? And you see so many like talented people, they're pushed young at a younger stage into the senior side.
You're talking about the domestic first class cricket. You know, a lot of people ask me that over the years. If you look back and I'll say last 10 years or last 15 years, Delhi has produced more Indian players than any other state. And that's the reason why sometimes whenever we talk, we have in a chat after the game or when we travel, a lot of people who follows cricket want to talk about what's going on in Delhi. It is interesting that when they ask this, and the answer is even more interesting, we have the most unstructured structure in Delhi. So if you ask me, is there a system? Is there some way that we are producing so many players in last, let's say, last 15, 20 years who's played for India? None. And I hope things will get better. I think it's the competition, is the example that the others have set, the others to follow. When you sit in the dressing room, when you look around and you see that guy who was sitting next to me is playing for India or inspiring to play for India, that healthy competition encourages you to work harder. When you walk into the Delhi dressing room, you have pictures on the wall, the people who have played for Delhi, the people who are, you want to be there. So that's the competition I see. And the other thing that I feel with my personal experience that, you know, when you don't have that sort of a structure, only cream comes at the top. So you keep fighting, and it's the healthy competition. When I talk about fighting, there are a lot of ways of fighting as far as Indian cricket is concerned. But that healthy competition where if he can play, I can play as well. So you go back and you start looking at that guy. How is he played? He's scored that many runs. He's taking that many wickets. And that's the reason why he's into the side. You come back next season. You come back next season much stronger, mentally, physically, performance-wise. And hope for the best and find a chance in the Indian side. Because if you ask anyone who's playing first-class cricket or who's playing cricket, the dream is to play for the India. And when you have that dream and you work hard and keep that thing and keep most of the thing right, you definitely get the desired results.
Right. And who was your childhood hero?
There's no brainer, to be very honest. When I was growing up, or anyone of my age, even older people than me growing up, Sachin Tendulkar, or you know, one and only Sachin Tendulkar. It's so interesting. What I was about to say is that same age, and even people who were older in that generation had somebody's poster who was 16 or 17 on the wall and wanted to be like him. I know, phenomenal what he's done for Indian cricket. How many people he's inspired or still inspiring is phenomenal. I'm like, if you played this game, you know the era in which he was playing for the country, what sort of a team we had, what sort of a team the other countries, the bowling attack that they had around that time, and his numbers, with people around him, is phenomenal. And his style, I think, even if I see that now, playing for country is a big prize, but playing for country with Sachin Tendulkar, even bigger.
And you too had a very decent, you know, run at the highest level and were unceremoniously dropped from the Indian team on the pretext of an injury, whereas you were really not injured that time. But you kept going on, you know, in domestic cricket. How was that phase in your life?
Well, I went on. That's why I'm sitting here and talking to you. You can sit home and sulk and go nowhere. Well, that injury thing and everything, I think it is part of parcel of the game. It happens. Whether it was there or it was not there, it happened such a long back. I don't even remember. What I look back, or if now sitting much more older, much more, I won't say wiser, but much more experienced, I look back and I say it was a blessing. Whatever I have today, whatever I'm doing today, part of the Indian side, played for India, is playing an immense role. I was touched disappointed when I got dropped because I was playing against Australia and the next door was Zimbabwe. So after playing, it was not that I was part of the squad 15, I was part of the playing 11. And I was in that series. I had a brilliant start. I was the first Indian wicketkeeper to score an international one-day 50 against Australia. That confidence was behind. So I thought, come Zimbabwe, I'll get another opportunity to cement your side because the series that we lost, it was a close series. We won the test series. But we lost the one-day series 3-2. But, you know, that feeling was there that if you're part of the side against Australia, which was the number one side around that time, come Zimbabwe, you'll get another opportunity to establish yourself in the Indian side. That didn't happen. But that part and parcel of the game, it happened with so many people. It happened people who were much better than me. So when I look back and look at the brighter side, I think I'm one of the blessed one that got an opportunity to play for the country.
Yes, that's true. And God always has a bigger plan, you know, always when there's something which you're not happy with. And but then there's always a brighter side.
That's what people say about me. Small man with bigger plans.
Right, that's true. And who gave you the maximum support?
Family, no doubt about that. You know, my mother, father, they didn't understand the game that much, but you don't want somebody to understand the game to support you. What do you need after? They can sense. It's not about how many runs you scored. The moment you enter the house, they can sense everything with your mood. If you didn't score anything, that advice was always there that tomorrow is going to be a better day for them. It's not about next match or something like that. Even if you scored 100, they were happy for your happiness. They were sad for your bad day or your challenging day. But that encouragement was always there. Even now, sometimes when I play a fun game or something like that, they still wanted to know how I've done. And they still want me to do the best than anyone else. That's what parents are all about. Amazing sport as far as my mother, father was concerned. And my two brothers, they also played the game. I think the support that I needed from them was, I'm talking about 99, 98, when education was the most important thing. And come 10th, come the board exam, that's where the big shift comes. Everybody start talking about education, studies and everything. That's where my brother came into the picture and I told my father that, you know, he can play this game. So let him continue. Don't put pressure on him as far as the studies were concerned. And that's where they came into the picture and helped me a lot.
Wow, wonderful. That's wonderful. So there's a question from the audience. They're asking, Gambhir ko gussa kyun aata hai?
Aapko Gambhir ka sirf gussa kyun dikhta hai? आपको तो नाम से ही पता होना चाहिए कि वो गंभीर है. आई थिंक वो एक हर किसी की एक अलग तरीके की पर्सनालिटी है. बहुत सारे लोग और मुझे लगता है कि इंडिया में ना लोगों को तुलना करने में बहुत बड़ा मजा आता है. लोगों को एक दूसरे के साथ कंपेयर करने में बड़ा मजा आता है कि वो खिलाड़ी उसकी तरह नहीं है, वो खिलाड़ी उसकी तरह नहीं. हर खिलाड़ी अगर एक तरीके से हो जाएगा और एक तरीके से ही व्यवहार करेगा तो फिर आपको देखने में बिल्कुल मजा नहीं आएगा. और हर एक खिलाड़ी का एक अपना तरीका है अपने आप को कंडक्ट करने का, अपने आप को मोटिवेट करने का, अपने आप से अपना बेस्ट तरीका लेने का. और सबसे जो महत्वपूर्ण बात है ना, देखने वाली जो भी क्रिकेट देखता है या जो भी किसी को समझता है उसको ये बात पता चलेगी कि गौतम गंभीर को जब गुस्सा आता है तो अपने लिए नहीं आता है. वो अपनी टीम के किसी खिलाड़ी के लिए लड़ रहा होता है या अपनी टीम की जीत के लिए लड़ रहा होता है या कोई चीज ठीक नहीं जा रही होती तो उसके लिए लड़ रहा होता है. तो ऐसा ही तो कप्तान चाहिए आपको, कुछ दिखाते हैं कुछ नहीं दिखाते हैं.
There you go. So do you think that BCCI should revive university cricket again in a big way?
I think BCCI is trying whatever they can. It's the universities, it's the colleges. They also have to play their part. I completely agree. Yes, BCCI need to do that. And they have done that a couple of years ago. I think 2 or 3 years back, we had inter-university games. And BCCI have showed them live on the television as well. So that was a great initiative. But coming back, it becomes very, very important for the schools, for the colleges to play their part. BCCI will definitely do whatever they want. But there need to be a demand. They need to be conducting something and then go to BCCI and say that this is what we've been doing for the last couple of years. Unfortunately, you know, that was the, now we talk about bench strength, now we talk about India A, under 19 and everything. Earlier, it was all university cricket, school cricket, which produced so many fantastic players. And now university cricket has almost taken a backseat. I've seen incidents in North where the university is happening earlier and inter-college happens later, unheard of. So right. You know the state of things, you know how the things is going on. So colleges and university need to put their act together. And then BCCI will definitely look into it, and they are trying whatever they can.
Okay. And your thoughts on MS Dhoni?
And in what way? As a wicketkeeper?
No, I'll play further while not retiring. What would he be thinking? What's going on in his mind? What are your thoughts about?
I mean, if somebody lives with him 30 years, then also that person doesn't know what he's thinking and what he's going to do next. that is MS for you. But what a phenomenal impact as far as the Indian cricket is concerned. There are players, but there are special players. There are brilliant players. There are great players. But there are players who will make impact. So as far as Indian cricket is concerned, Mahendra Singh Dhoni is one of those characters, one of those players who's made impact. And that impact is going to be forever. Whenever you're going to talk about Indian cricket, you will definitely have a chapter or a mention as far as Mahendra Singh Dhoni is concerned. And, you know, with him, character like him, he's not finished yet.
Wow, he is a very strong character, yeah. And tell us why did you name Shikhar Dhawan Gabbar? What did you see in him?
You know, when we talk about first-class cricket, it can get very boring. So one of the Ranji Trophy game was going at Feroz Shah Kotla. And as a coach, I was just taking rounds outside and just, having a word or two of encouragement to the bowlers who was working really hard, nothing happening at Feroz Shah Kotla at times. And Shikhar Dhawan was standing at Silly Point. And suddenly there, he said a dialogue of, surely.
Okay.
And he said that, and I could hear it because there are not many people as far as the first class cricket is concerned. If somebody is little loud, you can hear them. So I heard him, and I heard that thing, and I stayed away. I said, Gabbar. The moment I said Gabbar, there's no looking back. Since then, he's Gabbar.
So which dialogue did he say of Gabbar?
You know, there are a few things when we talk about whenever we do interviews, whenever we do things like that, anecdote, everybody wants that. But as far as the men's cricket is concerned, dressing rooms are concerned, dialogues are concerned, the jokes are concerned, they are only for that dressing room.
All right. So one untold story before we go. One untold story from the cricket field that you haven't shared with anyone that you would like to share?
I think once, it's nothing like that. There's so many stories. There's so many different sort of a story. And like I just mentioned, I answer that question before you even ask me this question. A lot of people say stories. There's so many stories. The biggest story is for anyone, any cricketer, somebody like me who's played his inning as far as playing on the ground is concerned, there is no better story than playing for country. I think you're blessed because everybody's out there trying, and it's nothing better than this. That feeling is unbelievable. And I think it doesn't happen unless until you need a lot of blessing, a lot of hard work. Everybody is working hard, but being true to yourself, no better story than that, playing for the country.
That's wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. It has been a pleasure talking to you, and such a nice sight. Even though we had connectivity problems, glitches, but we still made it.
Well, that's the story. That's the story of the time. At the moment, there's so many glitches around, but life is still beautiful. Thank you so much. Yes. It was really lovely talking to you.
Thank you. Thank you.